Watch this. The left shoulder goes into the right hip, caused by the contractions of the large muscles like the upper back, the lats, the obliques, and the glutes. Flipping this pose to the front, we see that the right shoulder goes into the left hip, caused by the contractions of the large muscles like the chest and the obliques. Where there is a contraction, there is a stretch, and those muscles had to be in a stretch position beforehand. The Serape effect works because of the stretching and shortening of these muscles. Given those key parts, the next step is to bring them together, creating three rotational segments including the torso, the hips, and even the head. Here my outstretched arms show how much range my torso can possibly rotate. My hips are stable down below because I am standing in the shallow portion of the pool. This stability allows my torso to freely move. Also notice how my head is anchored and stable too. The next step now is to decide on when to anchor the catch. If we do it as the body is rotating, the drag force from the entire lower arm will resist the torso's rotation. Biomechanically, the internal rotation necessary for the catch also adds a hitch that further resists the supposed rotation of the torso, which puts the big muscles in a stretch to wind up the Serape effect. This temporary deceleration of the torso causes the hip segment below to mobilize and lead the rotation instead. This has been popularly labeled as the hip-driven freestyle. Now what happens if we anchor the catch before rotating to the other side? That's when we get the kayak catch, popularly associated with the shoulder-driven freestyle. The torso in this case will always be mobile throughout the stroke, similar to the standing rotation drill I'm doing. Since the arm pull is already done catching before the rotation, the pull down is unrestricted and ready to coincide with a snappy rotation. What if we switch back to the front quadrant catch after the breath? That's when we get the hybrid freestyle. So the ending lands on overall rhythm and timing, which is controlled by multiple components but centered on the rotation. Here we catch during the deep drum beat as the body rotates, which stretches the lats and lets the hips lead. In this variation, the catch happens on the snappy end range before the body rotates back, relying on arm strength, then ripping through with the rotation. Then we have a choice to combine both.